Welcome to this lecture on the use of the LCA approaches for biocatalysis. LCA stands for Life Cycle Assessment of Processes. In the previous lecture, we have been studying the biocatalytic reaction as such, in which we have the substrates, the reagents, which are going to be converted into the products by the use of the enzymes. In this case, we were looking at how we can measure the impact and the strength of this reaction for industrial purposes. So we have, in principle, two kinds of metrics to be made. One is the environmental metrics. So we are going to, we were assessing how green the process could be or how ungreen this could be. And we had also the metrics related to the efficiency and production of the reaction. How many kilos of product can we make in a liter per gram of enzyme and so on. We were stating that if we want to be environmentally friendly and economically competitive at the same time, we need to find a place in the reaction in which both measurements are aligned. This implies highly intensified processes with high substrate loadings, which are going to be quite environmentally friendly and quite efficient at the same time. But this part is only measuring what is the reaction as such. So this is a very solid, strong basis, in particular when people are studying a new reaction in the lab or in research, thinking how to handle this. This is a very useful approach. But the big picture of the synthesis of a product is broader than this. So we need also to keep into account many other things that are beyond this measure. One aspect to be considered is the environmental impact that the production of the substrate, production of the solvents and reagents are going to create. And we have to think that these chemicals are going to be made usually in a different place from the chemical plant in which a reaction is taking place. This also is going to make an environmental impact in the process. In addition to this, we need to consider that we are making an enzyme, which in many cases is also producing fermentation in a different chemical plant from the one that we are working with. That means that we will need to ship it to the current place in which the reaction is going to be made. And also, we need to consider that we are making a product. The product is not going to end up in the plant, in the chemical plant, but it's going to be shipped and marketed and used in a different environment. That means that once that this is used, the product we are making is going to be disposed in the environment. So this is why we are going to see later the term starting with the cradle, starting with the production of the product, and we are going to end up with a grape, which is the disposal of the product that we are making. So on balance, what we need here is not only to look at the metrics that we have in the reaction as such, which is the first step, as I said before, quite important when you are working in the lab, but also we need to be more holistic and try to think in broader terms, how is the impact of the reaction? This is usually done by a number of tools which are called LCA, life cycle assessment. So this LCA approach is following some standardized rules, which can be seen here, these ISO rules, and a standard LCA is covering four main stages or steps to be made. The first one is that we have to define a goal and the definition of what we want to measure, which is the impact that we want to look at. The second one is we need to retrieve all the data based on literature and based on many places to have the data to consider how is the impact of each chemical, each process that we are making. Then, based on this inventory data that we are getting, we can make the assessment of the impact of the reaction, how made this is going to be made. And all of this is going to lead us to an interpretation of the reaction, how the different parameters, the different processes are going to make an impact in the environmental point of view. In all cases, this is going to be iterative. So we are going to see things that are being created here and are going to be back to the goal and inventory and the impact assessment phase to refine a bit how this is going to be made. The first step that we need to make in the LCA is to define what is called the functional unit, the FU, which is the amount of product we are going to take as a unit to make all the impact. This usually in biocatalysis in chemistry is taken as the generation of 1 kilo product. So what is the impact that is going to be made by a 1 kilo product? This would be probably also set as a goal of the LCA. In a second step, we need to define which are the boundaries of this functional unit. So we can start in production of the reagent, solvents, and transportation and the reaction as such, or we can start in a closer, as a narrower analysis, for instance, the K2 gate, which is considered only things that are being happening in chemical plants, but not beyond that. So in all cases, we need to define which is the energy we're going to need, which are the chemical masses that we're going to need, and which is the waste that we're going to make. So this is part also of the goal and scope because it's making us boundaries of the analysis that we want to make. Then we have the inventory data. So we need to get on the literature, on data from companies and patents and so on, which is the impact, the amount of energy and chemicals as we're going to need to make 1 kilo of our product. This is part of the inventory data that we have here. And then we need to measure the impact that any of these items are going to make. And we have the number of the things to be measured in the LCA. The most typical one is the greenhouse gas emissions that we are going to make. All of them can be unified to some units to make meaningful comparisons. And for instance, the greenhouse gas emission, the unit from which all of this is referred to the equivalent of CO2 produced per kilo of product. So everything that is going to be used in this case for the greenhouse gas emission is going to be benchmarked to the amount of CO2 that we are making in the reaction. Based on all these impacts that we get here, we can make an interpretation of our process. That means that we can start to compare options in the synthesis, options in the substrate, in transportations, where to allocate the chemical plant, where to make the molecules, and so on. And we can make comparisons to see which are the best options for the environmental process. In this case, we could set up recommendations. And then these recommendations can go back to this system to make a new LCI based on new ideas, on new points that we could have. So on balance, what we have in the LCI is this graphic that we have here, which seems quite complex, but it's not at the end, as we are going to see now. So we can have a cradle-to-gate analysis, we can have a gate-to-gate, and we can have a cradle-to-grave analysis. We are going to start from the gate-to-gate as a narrower one. This is the reaction as such that we have, the enzymatic reaction that we are making. So we are assuming that all reagents, all solvents, substrate, enzymes, and so on are already in chemical plant, which is this boundary that we have here. So the first unit that we are going to have is the upstream, in which a substrate is going to be converted into a product by the enzyme in a media. This is going to consume some energy that we have to put in the system and is going to create some wastes. Then we're going to have the downstream unit. The downstream unit, once again, we will have to add chemicals and the energy to make the process done. We have some kind of options that we can use here, decantation, washing, extraction, chromatography, etc. And we're going to make a waste again. And our LCA in this case is ending up here, is in the other gate of the chemical plant. We have a product, so we have made the product. This is the gate-to-gate. This could be related to what we see in previous lecture related to the environmental metrics. We measure what we have in this reaction. But then we can make it in broader. We can go to the cradle-to-gate study, which is also ending in the product at the gate of the chemical plant, but is broadening the analysis to this part, which is before we are in the chemical plant. We can consider that we are using a land to make our reagents, our solvents. We need to make extraction and synthesis of these products. We need to make the transportation of all the chemicals and so on to the chemical plant. And once we have here, we are going to have the same again as we have in the gate-to-gate. And finally, we can have a even a more extensive and broader study of the LCA, which is in cradle-to-grave. In this case, we start also in production of the, all the chemicals that we are going to use. And we are going to end later, once that the product has been used and is disposed in the media, with the formation, for instance, of CO2. So we are covering the entire picture of the process. Of course, the broader the picture, the most complicated analysis can be, because we have to get all the data from these things that we are using here. But of course, this is going to bring a more holistic vision on how green or ungreen a process can be. So on balance, from this short lecture on the introduction on the LCA, LCA approach is providing an holistic analysis of the environmental impact on the entire value chain, or some parts of it, depending on how we put the boundaries of the analysis. It's covering not only the biocatalytic step in most of the cases, but also the origin and logistic waste treatment of all the things that are being done. In many cases, LCA is an interpretation of things that we are having. So it can be discussed that the impact can be one or the other one, depending on how we use things and so on. But it gives a very valuable information of how to manage processes and how to improve them from the environmental point of view. The steps that we have in this assessment, as we said, are the goals and the scope. So we need to define which is the functional unit, which is the impact of 1 kilo product that we are going to make. Then we can get all the data that we are making from this reaction. Then we can measure the impact of some parameters, like, for instance, the greenhouse gas emission, CO2 production of the process. And then we can make an interpretation of the data that we are having. We can make iterations in the LCA. That means that once that we have the first round of the LCA, we can get new data from the reaction. People in the lab can bring up new data, new comments on how they are making the things, and we can iterate and improve our LCA with this new data that can be implemented there. We can have some options on the LCA. One is the cradle to grave is the broader one. We cover the entire chain, but we can also work on narrower ones, for instance, the gate-to-gate, as we see, in which we only are thinking in the biocatalytic reaction that we are using in the lab or in the chemical plant. So in the particular case of biocatalysis, I think we need to consider also the substrate, whether they are biogenic or petrochemical. We need to consider the environmental impact of the enzyme production. If we are going to immobilize enzymes, this is going to bring an impact too, and also the process as such to be considered. Finally, we produce a product. It ends up at the gate of the chemical plant. We can even broaden this analysis, but by studying how is this disposed and which is the impact that this is creating.